Hey guys, what's up? Eric Merced here. Welcome to an all new video. Today, I am going to be showing you how to simplify Clip Studio Paint's user interface. So just a few days ago, Clip Studio Paint for iOS and the desktop version got a new update. They pretty much overhauled the user interface. It looks much cleaner. It looks much better, even though what you're seeing now doesn't look too clean. It looks a little bit too cluttered, but I'm gonna show you how to take advantage of the new look to simplify this user interface. So you're gonna go from this to this. So by the end of the tutorial, I'm gonna show you how to get your whole interface to this more clean, streamlined user interface, just to get all of those distractions out of the way. All right, so let's get started. Okay, so there's a lot of work that we're gonna have to put into this. So go ahead and grab yourself a cup of tea or a cup of coffee and get ready to delve deep into this, because there's a couple of things that we're gonna have to do in order to clean this whole interface up. Okay, so the first thing we want to do is to pretty much get rid of the title bar or the title and menu bar. And in order to do that, we're gonna hit this button here with the three lines, and we're gonna tap on hide menu bar. And the reason we're doing that is because by tapping on this, everything that you have on that menu bar, you have it right here. So there's no need for that. So we're just gonna get that out of the way. The next thing we're gonna do is we're going to get rid of every single open palette in this interface. I'll just start by grabbing a couple of these palettes out and dragging them out. Like so, and then just hitting the little X to close the windows. Now you can go into one of the menu settings and close some of these, but I find that doing it this way gives you the best result in the end for the pop-ups that we're going to do, because we're going to have some of these pretty much pop up later on. And if we do it this way, they will function a little bit better. So I'm just gonna go ahead and delete all of these and speed up the video right now. Okay, now that we've gotten rid of all of our menus on the sides, we're pretty much getting closer to a cleaner user interface. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna replace all those menus that we closed, at least the ones that we need, and we're gonna put them up on top of this command bar. In order to do that, we're going to go ahead and hit the little sandwich menu here and go to where it says Clip Studio Paint. And you want to tap on command bar settings. All right, now before we do anything here, let's get rid of a couple of things that we don't need. For example, this right here for, I guess it's a help menu. We don't need that. So we're going to tap on it and we're going to click delete or tap delete. Same thing for this here. We're going to skip the snap lines. We're going to leave those, but we're going to go to the selection tools and we're going to get rid of those. And the reason we're getting rid of these is because when we make a selection, these pop up anyway. So we really don't need them. We're gonna leave the clear layer there. We're also gonna leave these little symbols that say PSD, PNG, and JPEG. We're probably gonna add something to that. And the reason we wanna have those there is because if you wanna save out as JPEG, for example, all you've gotta do is hit that little symbol for JPEG and it'll send you into the save as dialog and automatically it'll pick JPEG for you. The same thing for PNG and PSD. We're gonna leave the save, the open, and the new document symbols, and we're gonna take this Clip Studio symbol here and get rid of that. Now, one thing I wanna say is this, I'm setting this up the way I use Clip Studio Paint, but you can pretty much run with this and just set it up in a way that you want to set it up with. Okay. Now with those items that we don't need, or at least that I don't need, out of the way, I am going to go to, we're automatically in the command bar settings, we're in main menu. So I'm gonna go to file, because I wanna add another item to this. And I'm gonna export single layer, and I'm gonna choose TIFF, and I'm gonna add that. And then I'm going to drag that all the way here to the side. Right there. So I just want to quickly show you what that does. I know I explained it earlier, but I want to show you. So let's say I want to save this image as a JPEG. All I have to do is tap on the JPEG symbol. And as you can see, it'll say export single layer. It'll have the name of the file already, or you can rename it. And already automatically in the file type, it'll have JPEG. If I want to export it as a PSD, I'll hit the PSD. And it'll same thing, but it'll have a Photoshop document selected. So it's pretty nice to have that there if you want to quickly export stuff. If you didn't have that there, you'd have to go into File. You'd have to go into Export Single Layer, and then from there choose what you want to export as. So this makes it much quicker just to tap on those symbols. So let's get back that command bar setting. All right, now the next thing we want to do is where it says main menu, we want to tap on that and we want to hit on pop-up palette. Now on pop-up palette, we want to unfold display hide pop-up. All right, so now I'm going to choose tool and add that. But before continuing, I'm going to tap on the icon right next to it and I'm going to tap on add separator just to keep everything nice and tidy. I'm going to go ahead and hit subtool. Tool property. Let's see, what else do we want? You can add brush size to that, but I usually just control that in the tools settings, the tool property setting. All right, let's add some color wheels here. Add color wheel. Add the color slider. Color set. Let's go back to the icon before that and add a separator just to keep it again clean. Let's see. Layer. We're gonna add that, and again, go to the item before that and add a separator. All right, we wanna add layer properties. Gonna add a subview, that's very handy, but I'm gonna add a separator to that. And the final thing here that I'm going to add is the auto actions. I love to use my auto actions, okay. Now that's looking really good. So let's see what else we can add to this. You can add options, all right? You can also add individual tools. For example, if there's a specific pencil tool that you like, you can add it up there if you want. Now this is another feature that I just recently noticed, and I really love that it has this. So when you click on drawing color, it gives you a choice here to choose. For example, let's pick black because we are mainly drawing with black, right? So let's turn that to black and add it. So you see that there's a little square there that appeared with the color black. Now let's go get a new one, and sometimes, actually let's do blue. I like to draw with a blue line. So let's do that and let's add that and let's add one more because sometimes I like to draw with a red line. So there we go. So we have our command bar set up the way we want. Now the cool thing about this is that if we want to reach our tools, we just tap on the tool icon and we have our tools there, and we can just tap on whichever tool we want to use. All right, if we want to make changes to those tools, for example, if we want to pick a specific tool that we want to use, we can just hit this here. Now, usually what I do is, let me see, I like to switch these over. There we go. So we have our tools, we have our tools properties where we can change the size of the tool. We can make these longer if we want. And we can also change the type of tool we're using. We have our colors here. We have our layers here on the side also. We have the subview and our auto actions, and we can choose to change that into button mode to make it look better. So that's done. That pretty much cleans up our interface. So what is the next thing we're going to do? The next thing we're going to do is set up our sidebar. So we do that by, first of all, we have to go into Clip Studio Paint, Preferences, go to Interface, and right down where it says Edge Keyboard, we want to make sure it's set to swipe. So that way I can just swipe from the left to the right and get those popping up there. All right. The final thing we're going to do is to set up different functions to these T1, T2, T3, T4 keys. So let's get into that. Okay, so the next thing we want to do is pretty much assign keyboard shortcuts to these side buttons, to the T1, T2, T3, and so forth. The only downside of this that I find is the fact that these are labeled the way they are and you can't change them. So so for example, if we assign save to T1, we don't have any way of knowing that that button is the save button unless we memorize that it is the save button. So if you're going to set these up, you have to remember what you set them up as. And in order to set them up, we just go into the menu bar here, and then we go into Clip Studio Paint, shortcut settings. All right, it's by default is set to tool. So let's go ahead and get to the main menu. And even though we have save up in the command bar, it's nice to have it on the side so we don't have to be reaching for it. So what I'm going to do is going to hit file and expand that and go ahead and tap on save. And it's already set to command S as a keyboard shortcut, but I'm going to tap in there. And once that is selected gray as like so, I'm going to hit the T1. And what that will do is map the save function to the T1 button. All right. Now let's close that up and go to edit. And this is optional. You can set T2 and T3 to both undo and redo. The reason I'm not going to do it is because in Clip Studio for iOS, you can double tap and it'll undo, and tap with two fingers and redo. Or is that three fingers? So we're going to check and make sure that that is set up. We're going to go to Preferences. And we're going to go to Touch Gestures. And it's a two-finger tap to undo. And it's a three-finger tap. I said two fingers, but it's a three-finger tap to redo. So that's already set up. So for example, just to show you, if you're new to Clip Studio Paint or iOS in general, if, let's see, make sure that I'm in a layer that we can work in. If we do that, I'm going to tap with two fingers to undo, and I'm going to tap with three fingers to redo. So there's really no reason to set these buttons up to undo and redo. You can do it if you want, but that's already baked into the app itself. So let's go back to main menu. So we're not going to do the undo and redo for that. But if we were going to do that, we just tap on undo, for example, and tap where it says Command Z, and then tap on T2, right? And that would map T2 to the undo function. So, but we're not going to do that. What I'm going to do instead is, what I'm going to do is, let's go back to the shortcut settings, and I am going to go to options and go to brush size palette right here. And I'm going to map, select smaller preset than current. I'm going to map that to T2, and I'm going to select larger preset than current, and I'm going to map that to T3. All right. So basically what that does is with T2, it'll make my brush size bigger. With T3, it'll make it smaller. The next thing I'm going to do is go to Tools, and I'm going to select pen for T4. Now the problem here is if I tap on that P, you know, it sometimes it won't open, sometimes it will, sometimes it won't, right? Maybe if you double tap, it'll open. But if you're having a a problem with trying to get it to open up so that you can map it, just hit edit shortcut and then tap on T4, and automatically it'll set that to the pen tool. So let me show you what I mean by doing it this way. So I have the pen tool selected. So let's say I want to choose, by the way, these are my clip inker brushes. So let's say I want to do Rough Lad right there. Let's do that. So, okay, that's Rough Lad there. Let's say I change back, let's do the eraser here, all right? I got the eraser. Now, if I hit T4, it'll send me back to Rough Lad, right? If it won't send me to any other type of brush, it'll send me back to the brush that I was using. So this is why I like to map the whole pen tool, not an individual tool, but the whole pen tool to that specific shortcut key. And finally, the last one I want to do, you can do all of these, but I like to keep it simplified, is eraser. And I like using a kneaded eraser for when I'm sketching. So I'm gonna map this to T5 and click OK. So now if I hit T4, I'll have my selected pen tool. Let's do brush. That's the brush. Now if I hit T5, I'll get my kneaded eraser, but if I hit T4 again, you'll see that I'm back to using brush. It remembers the last tool that you were using. One last thing I want to talk about is just changing the color of drawing. If I hit the blue there, I'll be able to draw in blue. If I hit the red, I'll be able to draw in red. If I hit black, I'm back to drawing in black. And I like using this when I am using, when I'm sketching. So when I'm sketching stuff, I like to sometimes sketch in blue and or sketch in red, just to make a difference there, a visual difference of what I'm doing. So now that we've set all of this up, we want to save this just in case we need to, you know, change, just in case we need to change workspaces. So in order to do that, we're going to go back to the menu. We're going to go to Window. We're going to go to Workspace, and we're going to register workspace. And here we can give our workspace a name and click OK. I'm not going to do that because I already have my workspace saved. So you can always manage your workspaces by going to Manage Workspaces, and there you'll see your workspaces. So there you go. That's pretty much it. That's how you get a really clean user interface in Clip Studio Paint in the latest version. If you guys have any questions, make sure you leave them down in the comments section below, and I will try my best, no promises, but I'll try my best to get back to them and answer them. If you have any suggestions, something I missed or something that it could actually be done better, go ahead and leave it in the comment as well. Your feedback is appreciated. Until then, guys, thanks for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you guys in the next video. God bless and peace.